So let's say we are starting out, and I'm going to do this using an example. So let's say we start out with the following Boolean formula, x1 or not x2 or x3 and not x1 or x2 and not x2 or x3. And the way we're going to transform this into a network is we're going to do groups of vertices for each clause. So for this clause here, for this one here, and this one here. So this is our first group of vertices. And we're going to have one vertex for each variable in that clause. So this vertex here is for the x1. This vertex here is for the not x2. This one here is for the x3. For this one here, we're going to do another group. This one here is for the not x1. This one here is for the x2. And for that clause down here, we're going to do the same thing. So we have not x2, and here we have x3. And now we're going to draw a lot of edges. So from each vertex, we are going to draw edges to every vertex in the other groups. With one exception, we're not going to draw an edge if we have the same variable, but one is basically the untouched variable and the other one has a not. So x1 and x2, we're going to draw an edge. x1 and x3, we're going to do an edge. And x1 and not x2 also, but we're not going to do an edge here. And it works similarly for this one here. So not x2, not x1, that's something we don't care about. That's something where we draw an edge. Not x2 and x2, again, here we have a not. Here we do not have a not, so we don't draw an edge. And down here, that's fine. And here we have a case where we have not x2 and not x2. That's also fine. So we'll draw an edge here. It's only if we have a not and here we don't have one. So for x3, we can draw an edge down here. Down here, again, those are the same. So we do draw an edge. That's fine. And we'll draw one here. Now let's look at those here. So we already have all the edges over to this group. So we only need to look down here. And indeed, we have edges here. And the same thing is going to happen here. So x2, we are not drawing an edge to this not x2 here, and we're drawing an edge down here. And we've already drawn all the edges down here. So this is the network that we construct. Now, what about the size of the graph? So if the Boolean formula here has polynomial size. So we have n variables, or in this case, 3 variables. And we said that we're going to have the total length of the Boolean formula be polynomial in the number of variables. So if this length here is polynomial, then the network also will have polynomial size, because we have one vertex for each of the variables that occur here. So the size really doesn't change that much. We introduce edges, but you already know that the number of edges is quadratic in the number of vertices that we have. So the size stays polynomial, which is already good for our reduction. But now I still need to show you what satisfiability has to do with click. We're actually going to do this as a little quiz. So let's say that the Boolean formula has m clauses. So in this case, m is 3, but you can consider the more general case here. And then let's say that the graph that we have constructed has a click of size m. So one click of size m, for example here, because m is 3, would be this here. All vertices are connected to each other. There's others that you can find, actually. So if you can find a click of size m in a graph that was constructed this way, does that graph contain at least one vertex from each clause group? And by clause group, I mean the groups of vertices that we introduced for each of the clauses from our satisfiability formula. And what I would also like you to think about is if a click can contain multiple vertices from one of these clause groups here. So if we could have a click, say, for example, that could contain these two vertices here, or these two here, or in the more general case, if we can have a click that contains more than one vertex from each of these groups here. So please check those that are correct and leave the other ones blank.